Welcome back to UpTech REPORT's series on AI. In this video, we sit down with Alicia Klinefelter, research scientist for NVIDIA, and ask her to help define AI and the different types of AI that we often hear about. Alicia is an expert in her field. She has a PhD in electrical engineering from the University of Virginia. Since joining NVIDIA, her focus has turned more towards high-performance hardware, including machine learning circuits and systems. We start off first by asking Alicia to define AI and machine learning in her terms.
In terms of kind of the recent revolution, again, for me as a hardware engineer, I think of it a little bit differently than maybe someone who is more on the algorithms or kind of theoretic side. For me, I see it more as a revolution of finally having enough compute power, essentially, to do a lot of these complex algorithms that, you know, have been limiting this revolution for years. Because, I mean, a lot of the algorithms and the underlying mathematics of machine learning have been around for decades, since the 1950s. And really what kind of revolutionized these things is, you know, finally in the mid-2000s to late 2000s, we've been having this, you know, this enormous progression of compute power that has enabled a lot of us to finally kind of implement these algorithms at a larger scale. So to me, the power of AI is really in having those resources now available that weren't there before. So,
if you had to explain AI and machine learning in very simple terms, for example, to your mother or grandmother, how would you do it?
You know, it's the power for machines to learn at the most general level. It's the power of machines to learn through kind of iterative training, the same way that a child might learn. And I think, you know, that's usually the way I explain it to my mom is, you know, when you're first learning as a child, you know, you're given a lot of concrete examples of what something is. You know, you're given a series of blocks, and eventually you learn this is a block, and then eventually you learn about colors, and you can identify this as a red block. And I think, you know, a lot of AI is like that to me, where, you know, as long as we have the data, the training data, to essentially, tell a machine, you know, this is how you can classify different categories of things, then it can basically learn through a series of pretty simple arithmetic choices, essentially how to identify different or new things. I think beyond that, if my mom asks how, it might be a little bit more of a complicated answer, but it's really just the power for, computers we traditionally thought were only good at doing things we told them to do, to actually be more adaptive and to actually learn on their own. And I think, you know, that's the real power that we're starting to see now. So
let's take a look at the difference between AI and machine learning.
I usually think of AI as a superset of everything, and then really kind of machine learning is the implementation of how to get to this greater concept of artificial intelligence. That's usually where I kind of differentiate the two, where kind of artificial intelligence is just a super broad concept that can mean anything, essentially. And then machine learning, as I mentioned, is really that specific implementation of how you do it.
Let's take a look at some of the other commonly used forms. Can you explain the difference between machine learning, deep learning, computer visioning, and natural language processing?
So again, I think in this case, I would consider machine learning to be the superset of all these different types of learning methods, which deep learning is kind of one of them. Deep learning kind of only having been popularized in maybe the last decade, I would say, probably around with AlexNet, essentially, where you basically have these kind of multi-layer networks, which again, I think is something that was enabled more by the compute power. So, you know, in order to be deep in your learning, you need multi-layer networks. And in order to have multi-layer networks, you need to have a lot of complex compute power. So I would say, compared to the really simplistic models that used to define machine learning, which can encompass lots of different, other types of network topologies besides deep network or neural network topologies, you can even just do simple, linear regression, and that can be considered machine learning. So, there's a lot of different types of algorithms and network topologies that are under that machine learning umbrella. But, you know, something like deep learning or neural networks is something that's very specific within machine learning. And as far as I understand, the way I would describe computer vision is really just the ability, I think of it really as image processing, essentially, is the ability for a machine to look at an image or a stream of images and basically detect or parse something about that image, something unique. So I kind of genericize it as being like image processing. And I know that for a while that, you know, we have, a group of computer vision experts at NVIDIA. And I know for a long time before we even got interested in AI that, you know, they had relied on these very traditional algorithms to do a lot of their image processing, what I guess I would almost call a deterministic algorithm that someone had developed mathematically. You know, if you wanted to detect whether there was a car in an image, you know, there was a very deterministic way to say, you know, go through all the pixels and then identify these particular things and you'll figure out if there's a car. And then kind of machine learning came through and was able to kind of break all of their accuracy records for doing any type of image recognition or object detection. Natural language processing, as far as I understand, it's almost like it's a more specific application of machine learning is how I would think about it. But it's basically, you know, parsing language, essentially, almost as if a human being would. It's basically a specific model for processing language in machine learning.
This was just a taste. Stay tuned as we share the full deep dive interviews we had with each one of our panel of experts and our upcoming episodes focused on specific topics that will transform the way you think about artificial intelligence. All this on UpTech Report's new series on AI.